Hi. Okay, let me enter my room first. And it's quite a walk before I introduce myself. Wait.
Ooh, it's dark.
Okay. Sorry about the door. There's lights. So yeah. Yeah, tonight's video will be about a certain team whose base is in Woking, London. Okay. They announced that they will withdraw from the Grand Prix. Yeah. About a couple of hours ago. Yeah. Because of the coronavirus outbreak. Yeah, because one of their employees, or maybe one of the mechanics, has to be self-quarantined because of the COVID-19 or the novel coronavirus. Okay. So yeah. As you guys know that, F1, the Grand Prix is just around the corner, and if there's no Ferrari, there will be no Grand Prix. My saying wrong. If there's no Ferrari, there will be no Formula One. If there's no Formula One, there will be no Ferrari. Yeah. I nailed it. So, yeah. If Ferrari withdraw, the chances of having the race cancelled is pretty high. If Ferrari doesn't withdraw, the race will go on. But if one or two other teams withdraw from the Grand Prix, it's okay. But if Ferrari, the race will automatically be gone. Because of my saying just now, if there's no F1, there will be no Ferrari. If there's no Ferrari, there will be no F1. So, yeah, I'm just emphasizing my saying. Yeah. McLaren decided, the walking base team, McLaren decided to actually withdraw from the Grand Prix because of one of the members. As I told you, one of the members has to be self-quarantined because I think he's rumored to be rumored to have the COVID pos he's rumored to have the symptoms of COVID-19. Yeah, the corona something disease. Yeah, coronavirus. So yep, they are not going to race this weekend. And sadly, the other team is an American-based team. But I have a feeling that they will race this weekend. Because two of the members are also rumored to have symptoms of COVID-19. But they are not in the paddock. Okay. So, yep, that was quite a shocker. Okay, for me also. But it was a shocking news for me. After a couple of minutes, I read the article on the Formula One official page and everything else. I read the article. And I was thinking it was the right move from McLaren to do that, to withdraw from the race. they're thinking about their employees' health instead of just money. That sounds like someone who is now in charge of F1, and his company Liberty Media is also in charge of F1. So who might that be, the CEO of Liberty Media? Hopefully he decides to cancel the race, but the organizers will not be happy. But if you have to cancel something for the health of people, just cancel it. Easy. If you don't want to see anybody being buried in their graves pretty early, then cancel it. If you want to see anyone being buried early, don't cancel it. Sorry, that sounded a bit rough, but it's true. So I hope that the race is cancelled for the sake of the drivers and the teams and all the members of the paddock. Yeah. And also the pundits. Okay. Commentators lah. All those things, the fans, the people who is participate, the VIPs who are watching the race or everything, the sponsors. We are humans, so we don't want to die early. Or we don't want to end up in our graves early. So I suggest that FOM cancels the Grand Prix. If they are thinking about money, that means their brain is the same like our former Prime Minister's brain. I'm not talking about our 7th PM. I'm talking about our 6 PM. Yeah. I'm not going to mention it, their names. This is not a political video. Yeah, it's about F1. So yeah, I'm not going to mention their names to be on the safe side. So yeah, we should know we are Malaysians, right? So who's our 6 PM, who's our 7 PM, and currently who's the PM currently? So yeah. So back to my agenda. Hopefully if they have to abandon the first half of the season up until Singapore, okay. Sorry, up until Japan, sorry, 3/4 of the season, up until Japan. Okay. It's okay. Then South America, then Abu Dhabi will be the last race. But that would not be interesting. So I think they have plans to make the season more interesting. Yeah. Sadly, you are sacrificing people's life to do it. And that is utterly garbage or stupid. Sorry for my language. So yeah. Good job, McLaren. You did the right thing. Hopefully other teams follow that. Follow your footsteps. But if the Grand Prix is going to be cancelled without Ferrari being withdrawing, that would be great. But if Ferrari withdraws and the race is cancelled, all the fans, the neutral fans, will say that the FIA and the Formula Management are paid by Ferrari to do what they do best. To follow whatever Ferrari wants. So hopefully the Ferrari team doesn't withdraw, but the FIA and the organizers and also the Formula One management will cancel the event without Ferrari's withdrawal from the event. That would shut up. That would keep all the what do you call it? The cyber troopers off their fingers for a couple of weeks. But it's confirmed that Bahrain will be hosting a Grand Prix, okay, behind closed doors. It will be after Bahrain. It will be after the Australian Grand Prix. But maybe after Bahrain, it depends. There will be a few races in Asia after that. The China race, the Chinese Grand Prix is postponed. The Vietnam Grand Prix is 50-50. But rumored to be on, the Grand Prix will be on. Then after that, we will move into Zandvoort, then Spain, then Monaco, Canada, France, Germany, Britain, Hungary, Austria, and so on. Italy, I'm not sure about Italy because they are on lockdown currently. So we might not have an Italian Grand Prix this season. Okay. Then the Belgium Grand Prix before we move on to the two Asian leagues. That would be in October in Japan and Singapore. Singapore chances of having a race in Singapore is also in the air. That includes Japan also. Okay. Even what do you call it? In maybe Russia, but Russia has not had any cases of the coronavirus. So I think Russia would be on. US. US is 50-50. Mexico, Brazil, and Abu Dhabi, the last three races, also 50-50. But the best way is just to abandon this season and just zero rise everything. So by the way, if they abandon this season, it will be the first season, F1 season in their 70 years history to be abandoned. Yeah, first season, F1 season since the 1950s. So yeah, that's 70 years. Very long. I wasn't born yet. Yeah. I was born around 1998. That was for 38 years after F1 was formed in 1950. The first race was in Silverstone. Way back in the 1950s after World War II. Okay. I'm not going to get into F1's history. So I think I've made that video, right? Yeah. So yeah, I really hope if they can find a solution, they would just abandon season. Because I seriously know who would win 90% of the races, and who would also win the constructors' title and drivers' title. So I would suggest for them just to abandon the season. I'm not saying this because I'm a Ferrari fan, but I'm saying this as a natural, neutral fan. They should ban the season if there's a lot of races on the calendar is either postponed or has to be cancelled at the last minute. Might as well they just abandon this season. But it's a positive move from McLaren to do what they did, as I told you in the early part of the video. I'm really happy that they did that step, but I'm sad that the Haas team, F1 team, did not follow their footsteps. They did not follow their footsteps, sadly. So yeah, but the two members of the Haas team is self-quarantined either in the hospital or in their own hotel, but maybe in the hospital, because in the hotel it might the disease might be transferred to other people, right? Yeah, so including one of the McLaren members also. Yeah, maybe they are self-quarantined in the hospital in Melbourne. So yeah, hopefully, I hope if the season, the first race of the season is cancelled, I hope they abandon the season, seriously. Because they can't afford organizers of the Grand Prix can't afford to be organizing a Grand Prix if teams are withdrawing from the Grand Prix at the last possible moment. And yeah, because they have pumped up a lot of cash into the event. So yeah, so the cash will just get burned, and maybe there will be riots all over the place. So yeah, so adios, and good night. I'm happy for McLaren for what they did. So see you on my next video. Don't forget to subscribe, like, and share if you can all my videos. Okay, but if you can, just maybe two or three videos, that would be great. Okay, and also, if the race is on, I'm going to wish good luck to the both of the Ferrari drivers and Verstappen. Verstappen in Red Bull and one of the Mercedes drivers that might be Bottas, only Bottas. I don't really like Hamilton when he's behind the wheel. Okay, but if he's outside the cockpit or not behind the wheel, I like him as a person, but not as a driver, because he's like a celebrity. I don't like that. I miss those accustomed days where you are not allowed to be active on your social media accounts while in press conference. That should at least be reinstated back into the rule book. But sadly, thanks to Liberty Media, F1 is now, even there's a Netflix series. I'm against it, actually. Seriously, I'm against it. Raikkonen said, Netflix is just a hobby to me. That's what Raikkonen said. So yeah, So, yeah. And I'm going to say goodnight again. And this is officially goodnight. And bye.